Respected brothers and sisters, first of all, I'd like to welcome those of you returning from Hajj. It was an unique opportunity for you to be pilgrim to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's house this year. You have visited many blessed places, did many times Tawaf of Kaaba, stayed in field of Arafah, Mina, Muzdalifah, did Jamarat, Sa'i, Qurbani, cried to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot, did dhikr and so on. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your all good deeds. تقبل الله منا منكم وتقبل حجكم حجا مبرورا وسعيكم سعيا مشكورا وتجارة لن تبور. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable you to follow some Quranic recommendations after Hajj, as he stated in Surah Baqarah, ثم أفيض من حيث أفاض الناس. And another ayah, فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُم مَنَاسِكَكُمْ فَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَذِكْرِكُمْ آبَاءَكُمْ أَوْ أَشَدَّ ذِكْرًا فَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَن يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَمَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ. Long ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, so when you have performed your devotions to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then laud Allah's name as you lauded your fathers, rather a greater lauding. But there are some people who say, our Lord, give us everything in this world, and they shall have no resting place. And there are some people amongst you who say, our Lord, grant us good in this world and good in the hereafter, and save us from the punishment of the fire. According to that ayah, there are some tips we should remind you to continue. Number one, do more tawbah and istighfar, and be busy with Azkar, everyday Azkar, whatever you have memorized during host time over there. Number two, the biggest zikr is, according to the ayah, وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِلذِّكْرِ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, to perform daily 5 times salah in your local mosque with jama'ah. Don't ignore it. You have learned to pray 5 times over there. Now you have to continue with this good deed. Third one, do more dua for acceptance of Hajj. You have done it, but now you have to do more dua for Qabool. And also avoid all haram activities in your next life. My dear brothers and sisters, we'll receive the new Hijri inshallah from tomorrow, bismillah. We should use this opportunity to learn lessons and admonitions from the last year and prepare ourselves for next year. This new year reminds us of a great incident which was a turning point of the history of Islam. It is Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's migration from Makkah to Medina. The Islamic Hijri calendar, which is based on sighting the moon, our whole worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is based on it. We offer prayer including Jummah and Eid, observe fasting, doing Hajj, and giving zakah according to the Islamic calendar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, هُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ الشَّمْسَ ضِيَاءً وَالْقَمَرَ نُورًا وَقَدَّرَهُ مَنَازِلَ إِلَىٰ آخِرِ الْآيَةِ. It is He who made the sun to be shining glory and the moon to be light of beauty, and measured outer stages for it, that you might know the number of years and the count of time. My dear brothers and sisters, this Hijri year reminds us of the Islamic calendar, which most Muslims country ignore and neglect nowadays. Hijri calendar is entity of Muslims. We should understand. Every Muslim should be proud of it, proud of using the Islamic calendar. Other nations feel proud of their own calendar. The Chinese, the Bangladeshi, and Jewish people have their own calendar, and they are proud of it. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ عِدَّةَ الشُّهُورِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ 12 شَهْرًا فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ. Surely the number of months with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is 12 months in Allah's ordinance since the day when He has created the heavens and the earth. When a new year comes, people are very, very busy to celebrate this year, the day, through their own cultural activities. Is the cultural activities more important for Muslims to celebrate New Year than reflection or evaluation and planning for the new coming year. More structural way to have a positive motivation and impact in your next life. Have we checked our previous diary of whole year? How much sins we have earned in last year? How many people we have been upset? How much money we spent in wrong way? How much wrong attitude we have shown to our family, our colleagues, our children, wives, everybody? Have we repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enough? Have we cried enough to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness? Have we doing enough sincere tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and doing istighfar enough for ourselves to be forgiven? Have we done enough sincere tawbah? Have we apologized to the relevant people? Let's try to do so and reflect as Umar radiallahu anhu reflected and reminded us. He said, Hasibu anfusakum qabla an tuhasabu. Your accountability will be taken by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before that, you have to check yourself. And you have to have your own accountability. Check yourself and correct your future. Now, how you use excellence of the month of Muharram and the day of Ashura. The month of Muharram is the first month of the Hijri calendar in which fasting is recommended, as it is one of the four sacred months. It is narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions used to fast on the 10th of day of Muharram while they were even in Mecca. When Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam migrated to Medina, he was reported that the Madanian people, the Jewish people, they used to fast on the 9th of Muharram. The companions of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked them, why you fast on that day, O people of Medina? They have replied to them and said that it's a great day for us, for our Prophet Sayyidina Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, as he was rescued on that day and his whole enemies were destroyed. Therefore, we fast on the 10th of Muharram. Then Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said to them, okay, if you fast for respect of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, then I have more right upon Musa alayhi salatu wasalam to respect him. I'll fast from now on 2 days, the 9th and 10th of Muharram. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma quoted the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, La in baqitu ila qabirin la sumanna tasi'. If I live next year, then I'll also fast on the 9th. As Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in another riwayah, Afdalu siyami ba'da shahri ramadana shahrullahi al-muharram. After the month of Ramadan, the best rewarded fasting is fast of Muharram, subhanallah. And after Fard Salah, the best rewarded Salah is the Salah of Qiyamul Layl, night prayer, late night prayer, Tahajjud prayer. Dear brothers and sisters, finally, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our prayers, Ameen. Hajj, and our all supplications. Ameen. We ask Him to guide us all and enable us to avoid munkarat and grab the reward of this great month of Muharram. Ameen.